Hey everybody, I'm Emily Roberts. I'm a Diamond Ambassador of Plexus Worldwide. Welcome to my house. We're currently moving right now, so that's what you're looking at. I want to invite you guys to learn new ways to follow up, learn new ways to contact people, because a contact is a contact is a contact. Sometimes we get so caught up in who we need to contact, we forget the people we know awesome other people, and those people know even more awesome other people. It's called networking. And I think we forget to do that sometimes. We forget to network. We forget to ask for referrals. And sometimes we just get really, really scared about contacting people in our Plexus business. So I kind of want to hit some key points with y'all today and maybe light a fire under your rear to get you excited to go out and contact people. And what better way than to start this on a Monday so you have a full week ahead of you to get your butt in gear and to, you know, find that Celeste Gwynn, find that future double diamond on your team. So what I'm referring to is one of my favorite network marketing books. I feel like everyone that is even attempting to do a network marketing business, especially Plexus, should read this book. It's called GoPro, and it's by Eric Worre. And this book was super, super business changing for me. It took me 8 months to get it out of a closet and read it. And I totally regret that because it makes me wonder where my journey would have gone if I would have read it sooner. So this is me telling anyone watching this now or in the future to get yourself and get your hands on GoPro so you can read this and learn how to do network marketing the right way, and then also learn why it's better, because network marketing is so much better. So what I'm referring to is found on page 55 in GoPro, and it's called the super indirect approach. When we are following up with people, when we are approaching people about our business, more often than not, we are going to come across as salesy. That's just how it's going to be. And that's for two reasons. Number one is the person that you're reaching out to thinks you're trying to sell them something, so you're already accidentally a salesperson. Number two, the way and the words that you are saying make you sound like a salesperson. And maybe you're not meaning to. Maybe it's totally by accident. So that's what we're going to work on today. On page 55, he talks about the super indirect approach. And I love this because Eric Worre is kind of, he's kind of sarcastic. But It's for me personally, I need someone to use tough love on me so I know how to do it right, the correct way and the first way. I don't want to keep, you know, creating all these terrible habits and following up in a poor way. So this is why I really like the super indirect approach, especially because 99.99999% of my business comes from my Facebook audience, and maybe yours does too. So that's why I like this approach. This is his third approach. If you read the book, he has other approaches on contacting people, but this one is my favorite. He talks about how it's incredibly powerful because it works on a number of psychological levels. In this approach, you tell the prospect that they aren't a prospect and you're just interested in finding out if they know someone else who might benefit from your business. It's very effective. You guys, I started using this approach with my husband and his team because my husband is not a people person. He loves people. Don't get me wrong. He's like a super big teddy bear guy. But it was super awkward for him because he was so skeptical and hated on Plexus so long. It was hard for him to just go tell people, like, look, yeah, I know I said I hated it, but now I like it, so you should try it. So this indirect approach, which is kind of like reverse psychology, is how we started approaching his friends and our family and mutual friends of ours. And it worked wonders because now he's a Ruby ambassador. So, warm market. Those are the people that you know, you see on a regular basis on Facebook. Maybe you run into Susan at Target like every Tuesday because y'all's kids have the same nap time. This is your warm market, people you run into all the time. So here's an example of sending a contact. You're just reaching out for the first time. You've already talked about how they just got married last July. You've already talked about plans for dinner in the next couple weeks because you miss them. You already have a friendship, okay? This friendship is in place. You casually contact them here and there, but now you're ready to bring up Plexus. Now you're ready to just grab the bull by the horns and say, all right, this girl needs to be on my team. So this is an example that Eric Worre uses. The business I'm in clearly isn't for you, but I wanted to ask, who do you know that is ambitious, money motivated, maybe would be excited about adding more cash flow to their lives? Obviously, you don't want to throw in the, but sometimes that's how it comes out. Let's be real. I use this same exact approach, but maybe you've heard me call it the magic text. sometimes we're messaging people, sometimes we're texting people, and you just cannot find the right words to say. You want to bring up Plexus. You want to tell them about Plexus and everything it's done for you. The products have changed your life and your health. The extra income has helped you keep the lights on in your apartment. Maybe it's kept diapers on your babies. You want to tell someone that, but you don't know how to say that. You shut down. So the best way to do this, when you know that person is meant to be on your team, is, hey, I know this may not be for you. That's totally cool, but I'd like to tell you more about it. That's what I've been doing. That's the approach that I use. I call it the magic text. So Eric Worre is kind of taking it a step further and saying, look, I know this isn't for you, but do you know someone that does want these three things? Because maybe that person will sit there and go, well, I want those three things. I was just telling my husband how much I couldn't stand my job. Or my husband was just telling me how much he couldn't stand his job. We want to stay home with our kids more. You just never know if you approach them in a reverse psychology way that it might finally click for them. Another way is, who do you know that might be looking for a small business that they can run in their home? Hello, single mamas and stay-at-home mom alert. How many of you know stay-at-home parents? I think all of us do. How many of you know college students that need extra income because they're sick of calling their parents for money? We all know someone that could benefit from just a little extra income. And I'm the first person to say, I get it. It seems very expensive at first. But if you look at the amount of things that you are spending money on, Diet Coke, Starbucks, whatever your fancy is, that's a cost objection that you can use during that follow-up, during that contact. We'll get to the follow-ups in just a second. But when you're contacting them and you're afraid, okay, well, they're going to shut me down. You already have in your mind that they've already said no, but you don't even know that. So go into it with an open mind and use that reverse psychology. Like, hey, I know you're in college. Do you have a friend that is looking for a small at-home business? I would love to show them a way to bring in some extra income. I used this approach two nights ago. My husband and I had a date night, and we were walking in this little market town thing by our house. And there was this really cool uppity store. It's like under the moon or south of the moon. I don't know, but it was a really cute store. And we walk in, and this girl, her name's Gina. She's not on my team yet, but she will be one day. I walk in, and she was just so excited and personable and was like, oh my gosh, welcome to our store. Your baby is so cute. I could just eat him up. And she just came right over to us, start talking. Well, come to find out she's Italian. So maybe that's why she's so personable. But she was so down to earth, and I immediately shut down and we kind of wandered away. She started folding clothes and I was like, babe, I want her on my team. I love her. She's adorable. And she will talk to anybody. She was doing that same welcome to every single person that walked into the store. And Scott is sitting there going, Emily, go up to her. Tell her that. Have some cojones to go up to her and be like, look, you're awesome. I'm awesome. I have an awesome Plexus team. Let's do this together. And I said, no, I'll just walk away. So I kind of did like a 360 of the store. Finally worked up some courage, and I was like, hey, this is totally out of my comfort zone. Even at the top of my company, I get super nervous. And so I already have her attention. One, because I'm about to ask her something, and she thinks like I'm a total psychopath. And two, I said something about being the top of my company. And so she kind of looks at me, and she goes, okay, I'm intrigued. What do you want to know? And I said, have you ever heard of network marketing? Have you ever heard of Plexus? And she was like, I've heard of network marketing. I don't know what it is. And I've never heard of Plexus. And so I don't know, just asking her that question, like my walls came down and it was just like the floodgates open. And I shared with her my story. And she right then in that moment added me on Facebook. Now we have a connection right here. And she's like, you know, I'm always looking for extra money. Come to find out she's a dance teacher. She has tons of networks. She knows plenty of parents that are looking for more energy. And I almost gave that opportunity away. I almost gave it up. Her coworker is someone that looked really familiar, and believe this or not, she was super kind of introverted and shy, but I gave her a sample too, and I told her about the business, and I was like, all right, y'all have a great weekend. I'll find y'all on Facebook. Well, my husband and I, we go to base yesterday to grab some like paper towels and cleaning supplies because we're packing, and that coworker, the silent one, the one that didn't say a word to me but still took the sample and listened, she works on base too. She worked behind the jewelry counter at the PX, and I was like, hey, I met you on Friday night. How are you? And she's like, I'm great. And I was like, you are a woman of many trades. You work everywhere. And she was like, yeah. She was like, I knew you looked familiar. She was like, you are the crazy places lady. And I said, yes, I am. She was like, I've seen you in here before. Some of the ladies have talked to you, and some of them are on your team. And I was like, yeah. And she was like, maybe I should do this too. Why not add it to all my other jobs? And I was like, oh my gosh, if I would have never opened myself up to Gina, the girl that I was initially doing, I wouldn't have had that second follow-up contact. So all of that to say, get out of your comfort zone. Do it today. It's Monday. You have 6 more days in this week to try to get out of your comfort zone at least once. Make that initial contact. You know, Facebook is really a safe zone because you have that keyboard courage and you can message someone and they either say yes, no, or they block you, right? I mean, that's kind of what it boils down to. Jennifer Brett almost blocked me. So I want you to know that there is some peace in knowing that not everyone blocks you. Sometimes they join your team and they go see your roomie. So have some confidence in that because Jen can be our living proof. So get out of your comfort zones and use this super indirect approach. Another version that Eric Worre uses is, who do you know that has hit a wall with their business and might be looking for a way to diversify their income? Now, that is super like white collar sounding to me. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'm not going to go up to people and say that to them. I'm going to say something more along the lines of, hey, I know you're a stay-at-home mom and you run the PTO meetings and you run the bake sales and you're like the soccer coach, but how about adding one more hat? How about adding one more thing? I think you would be perfect on my team and I'd love to tell you a little bit more about that and offer you some extra energy for doing all of these crazy tasks that you're doing. You never know what they might say. So, super indirect approach. Another one that you can use is something that we just did a couple weeks ago in the small business challenge, is getting out in your town. If you are too afraid to approach people on Facebook, on Instagram, if you're not ready to post on social media, that's great. Go out into your town, take 5 samples of Plexus Slam, some 5 business cards, and walk into different locations, hair salons, nail salons, tanning beds, the bank, the gym, different places. Now, I'm not telling you to get in trouble for soliciting. I don't want you to solicit. You can even go to the small mom and pop shops in your town and just say, hey, look, I work for a small company, or I own a small home business. I'm trying to get my name out there. Maybe you know other small business owners, or if it is a small business, hey, you're a small business too. I'll pat your back if you pat mine. You know, can we help each other out here? I'd love to tell you a little bit about my business and I can help, you know, advertise for you and yours. It's another great way of just putting yourself out there. That first contact doesn't have to be as scary as you think it is. Sometimes your first contact could simply be posting a picture of your pink drink by itself on Facebook and saying, I'm really loving this energy today. Wow, I've been missing out. Something super generic like that. You don't have to say the word Plexus. You don't have to post a selfie. You don't have to be obnoxious. Just a picture of your products. Maybe that first contact, and you don't even realize it. So think about those things today. And if you need more direction, I'm referring to GoPro and Eric Worre. This is page 55, chapter 6 on the super indirect approach. Now, another part of that is using the if I, would you. And this is a really cool concept because you can use this with all of your potentials, and it's a great way to start learning how to follow up with your potentials. If I give you a stick of Slim, would you try it? Let me know what you think about it. Let me know if you felt any energy or what, you know, just your opinion in like 3 days and let me know. Again, it's if you did something for them, would they do something for you? And most people will say yes. One, because they love a free sample, and two, because you're doing something for them. So they feel like they need to return the favor. It's that psychological effect again, right? If I gave you a brochure or some printed material to read about Plexus, would you read it and let me know your thoughts? If I sent you this video to watch about the Plexus products, would you tell me which ones you're interested in taking? Those are really, really easy ways to get the ball in their court. And it's a question, so they're going to have to answer you eventually. Those are easy first contacts. And all of this is found in GoPro, chapters 55 through 57. I'm not some genius. I know. I like to think I am. But Eric Worre has done it for you. He's laid the path for you. So let's kind of dabble into follow-ups. We're about 20 minutes in, so I don't want to keep y'all too long. So you've made that first contact. You've asked someone, hey, if I give you a packet of Slim, would you try it? And then in like a week, I'll follow up with you. Like, and I want to hear what you think about it. They're probably going to say yes. So you mail it to them. They get it. It's been about a week and you're going to follow up. Before you follow up, here's a couple things that you can do. One, when do you follow up and how? The best way to do so, for me personally, I know we have a lot of hands-on people, so maybe it's an Erin Condren planner or a planner or some sort of desktop planner that you can write down. All right, it's the second. I'm contacting Susan today on the second. I told her I'd contact her in a week. Okay, the ninth. Contact Susan again. Did she like sample? Write that in your planner. Write it in your planner and remember that if that's what you like to do, if you visit that planner every day, you keep it in your purse, you keep it open on your counter, write it down. If you're more like me and you have 5,000 tabs open in your brain, like a computer or an iPhone, maybe you need something that will alert you. Jen, that's really pretty. Open up your phone, go to the calendar on your phone, and create an alert. Create a way to remind yourself, oh my gosh, it's been a week. I need to message Susan. Sometimes all these messages, you're contacting people, you're reaching out, you're following up, you're building relationships. If you're just using your Facebook Messenger as a way to follow up, you're going to lose contacts. You're going to forget. Those people are going to move on, find another ambassador or find another company with someone that's followed up better with them. So find the easy way for you to follow up. Another great tool for following up is from an idea that Allie Edmond shared was a tickler file. This is actually something I used in corporate America, and I can't believe I've never applied it to my Plexus business. Get yourself an index card box, those little boxes. We had them in like kindergarten for our colors and stuff. Get yourself an index card box, and inside 1 through 31, those are the days of the month. And you're going to have an index card for each person that you've contacted. Get 5 cards out every day. Hold yourself accountable. I'm going to contact these 5 people today and write down why you're contacting them or what you talk about. And then say, hey, I'm going to follow up with you in a week. I know you said you're not ready today, but I'm just going to check in then. Maybe they're trying a sample. Maybe they're watching a video. Whatever that initial contact is, you're going to give them a timeline to follow up with. So you follow up with them and you're going to move that card from the second, number 2 of the 1 through 31, you're going to move it to the 9 because that's 7 days later. It's a week later. So then when you get to the 9th of the month, you wake up, you do your thing, you come sit down, you work your business. You're going to open your index card box and you're going to go to number 9 because it's the 9th of the month. And all of those people are the people you follow up with. I love the tickler file system. Allie, thank you for reminding us if you're on the call. If you don't know what I'm talking about, maybe you need more visualization. I have them holding a baby or else I'd show y'all. Get on Google, get on YouTube, find someone that can explain the tickler file a little bit better. I'm telling you, it's going to rule your world, and it's going to help you follow up and not forget your contacts. Another awesome way to follow up is something that I think we should all remember. When you follow up with someone, always end it with a question. When you end it with a question, you're leaving the ball in their court so that they have to return the favor and reply back to you. Now, that's not always the case. We have people that ignore us all the time, right? We have people that read our messages and don't reply. There's a lot of reasons behind that. One, it's not their timing. They're not interested. It's not their timing. It's just like the coffee pot analogy. You go to Cracker Barrel and eat with your family, and the waitress walks around and says, can I get you some more coffee? Okay, here. Can I get you some more coffee? And you're like, oh, no, I'm good. Thanks. It's the same concept. They're not telling you no. They're just saying, no, not right now. I'm full. I have plenty. I have what I need right now. Come back later. That's why it's so important to follow up. We can't just shut down when we get those no's, not right now's. Maybe it's a message that's been read and not replied to. You have to revisit them and follow up later. If you keep getting ignored, give it 2 months. A lot can happen in 2 months. A lot can change in 2 months. If they are not responding to you and it's been 2 months, try again then. Post on their Facebook wall and say, hey, I messaged you. I hope all is well. I've been thinking about you. Just open it up that way. Now, another great thing to remember when you're following up is not just ending it with a question, but remembering that less is more. You want to kind of play volleyball with them. Think about volleyball. Ball goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth until, boom, spike. Somebody does something and the whole conversation stops, right? The whole game stops. And so you spike that ball. They get a point. It's over. You don't want that to happen. you don't want to send something their way and have them shut down. Usually when we send 5 articles, 2 videos, your personal testimony, like 4 pictures of yourself and your results, people are going to be like, oh my gosh, you just sent me a textbook. I don't have time to read that. That's not how you follow up. Start using this method, 2 sentences or less. When you are following up with someone, 2 sentences or less will do it. And it's usually a statement and a question. Oh, wow, I'm really glad to hear that you're interested in working out and you're taking care of your health. Which Plexus products were you interested in? I saw you liked my post. 2 sentences or less. You don't have to send them 5 articles on why gut health is so important when their main goal is weight loss and headaches. You have to listen. You got to pump the brakes, take a step back and be like, all right, you have my full attention. Stop reading 30 messages at one time. Put your kids down for a nap. Invest into that person and build a relationship and figure out why they really want Plexus. They may have asked you about weight loss. They may have asked you about having more energy, but you have no idea if they really need money to keep the lights on. You have no idea if it's a mom going through a divorce that nobody knows about. So listen, that is the most important part of following up, is listening. So 2 sentences or less, listening, and then ending every follow-up with some sort of question to leave the ball in their court to keep it rolling until they're ready to say yes and you close the deal. When you are following up and they are finally ready to dive in and they are like, yes, I'm on your website, I'm signing up right now, stay with them. Do not go to dinner. Do not leave them hanging. You stay with them and say, okay, I'm here to walk you through it. This is how you're going to do it. Top right corner, click join. Then you're going to click the big gray button if they're brand new. If not, and they're upgrading from being a customer, scroll down and click upgrade to ambassador. Next, you're going to pick your welcome pack. Why? Because it's the biggest discount you're ever going to get on products. And you have 60 days to pick one if you can't do it today. Next is your backup order option. These are your products for next month so you don't forget to order them. And it shows Plexus you're an active ambassador or active wholesaler. Next, fill out your payment info. Fill out your name. I'm so excited. Get them pumped. Be like, oh, I'm making your welcome picture right now. I'm adding you to my team page right now. That's still part of following up, because you may tell them, all right, thanks, you're joining my website, cool. And you go to dinner and they have like 6 questions and they're like, wow, where'd she go? I'm joining her team and that's it? Like, she's just going to leave me hanging? Stay within that moment. It goes back to listening. It's kind of the same thing. Stay in that moment with them so that that momentum builds and builds and builds and their excitement stays there. And then guess what you're going to do? You're going to set another reminder. You're going to write in your calendar, did Susan get her welcome pack today? Sorry, someone's beeping in. You're going to write on your calendar, did Susan get her welcome pack? It's been 10 days. Shipping has been delayed, but guess what? It's back up and running. So about a week out should be good. Following up is everything. Before they're a customer, while they're a customer, and especially right when they join as an ambassador, you have to check on your team members. And it all goes down to that first initial contact, you guys. There's nothing more exciting than contacting someone and them going, you know what? I've been waiting forever for you to reach out to me and ask to be on your team. I've been waiting forever for this message. And I'm like kicking myself going, oh my gosh, why was I such a chicken? So I challenge everyone today that is on this call. There's about 33 of you. I challenge all of you to get out of your comfort zone from now until Sunday. Go reach out to that chickenless person and just contact them. Hey, how are you? Hey, let's get lunch this week. Hey, you want to take your kids to the park with me? Contact them. Get yourself out of the house. Go up to that store clerk in your favorite store at the mall and be like, you know what? You are adorable. I love your personality and I want you on my team. And they're going to be like, say what? And you whip out a pink drink pack and you say, try this. You're going to see why you want to be on my team too. Y'all have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for being on this call. I hope I've kind of shed some insight on following up and making that initial contact, because it's not as scary as you think. I love you guys. Thanks.